is the time. Mu'jizat, miraculous power, are for prophets. عليهم أفضل الصلاة والسلام وعلى نبينا أفضل الصلاة والسلام. أولياء, they have كرامة, means they have, Allah gave them because of their love to Prophet and their love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and because of their piety, Allah gave them a kind of, is not mu'jiza, mu'jiza only for our anbiya, is they inherited from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam things that Allah gave them to their hearts knowledge, that they know things before its time, or Allah gave them healing power that they can heal by recitation or by blowing or by reading something from Holy Quran and Hadith of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heals the patients. Every person likes to be a wali. But awliyaullah are being chosen. They are not prophets. They are pious people. Allah has chosen them and in every time and in every century they are between the ummah, looking after the ummah's interest. Whatever it's needed, they will try to help. If awliyaullah are not between the ummah present, since long time would have been seen the destruction of this world. They are the pillars that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put them like mountains to stabilize this world. To stabilize the spiritual aspect of life by destroying the amal of Iblis and his army and producing their amal that Allah likes and granting it to the ummah without anything in return, giving it as if the ummah has done it. They will do it and they will give it the benefit they give to the ummah. And that's why this ummah, ummatun marhuma, ummatun maghfura. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this ummah is a ummah that has been granted mercy, has been granted forgiveness, because it is the ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given inheritance, gave from him to these awliya to keep that spiritual levels and support to the ummah by destroying the amal of shaitan. And on the other side, they are also balancing the physical life of this world by trying to minimize the destruction of evils from being able to attack on earth. This 15 of Sha'ban is carrying a lot that Awliyaullah are scared from what's coming up. Many Awliya last night, they were asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through their prayers and through their du'as, after they have been seen what's going to happen this year, are asking for forgiveness on behalf of the Ummah and asking for delay of big events that's coming in front of us. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned a hadith that it been authenticized in tafsir Surah Al-Asr, Al-Asr inna al-insana lafi khusr. In the meaning of that surah, there is a hadith that been mentioned in the tafsir of that surah and has been authenticized, that it is an authentic hadith, is being mentioned in tafsir Ruh al-Bayan. It says that in saluhat ummati falaha ma'ishatu yawm. If the ummah is in good shape, Allah gave the ummah a life of one day. And if وَإِنْ فَسَدَتْ فَلَهَا مَعِيشَةُ نِصْفِ يَوْمٍ. And if it is corrupted, it has a life of half a day. وَإِنَّ يَوْمًا عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ كَأَلْفِ سَنَةٍ مِمَّا تَعُدُّونَ. And one day to Allah is 1,000 year. So means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in tafsir of Surah Al-Asr, Allah is giving an oath in Al-Asr. Asr means the prayer, Salatul Asr, or means the time, the Dahr. He's giving an oath that this Ummah has been granted 1,500 years of age. Awliyaullah knows that this dunya will not live more than 1,500 years. Today, we are 1,422 years of Hijratul Nabi, alayhi afdalu salatu wassalam. Add on that from the time of Bi'asatul Nabi, another Bi'asa when he was 10 years, add on that 10, how many years become? 1,432 years. Allah gave the Ummah 1,500 years. That is the life of the Ummah, means what is left is 68 years. In it, Zuhur al-Mahdi, Zuhur Sayyidina Isa, staying of Sayyidina al-Mahdi 7 years, Sayyidina Isa 40 years. Alamatu al-Sughra, the small signs and the big signs. And all are going to be in these 68 years. Awliyaullah, that night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed them what's going to happen in this year. And every wali, depend on his level, he asked protection for his followers. 313 from Awliyaullah standing at the foot of Shuhada Badr, Ashab Badr, companion of Prophet in Badr, and standing at the foot of 313 messengers. There are 313 Prophet's messengers. These are inheritors, and all these 313 are from murid of Mawlana Sheikh Muhammad Nazim Adil Al-Haqqani, are Awliyaullah from his murids, that till now they are not knowing themselves yet. Some of them they know, are being chosen from these hundreds of thousands of murids. 313 are on that level. Has been given permission for reaching Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam Rawdatu Sharifa, his holy grave, and they are going to be invited by one of the greatest awliya of this time. His name is Sayyidina Yunus al-Thani. There was one Yunus before mentioned in Holy Quran. He is a prophet that the whale swallowed him and then he threw him out because he was musabbih. He was always praising Allah in the whale's tummy, belly. There is one wali that is inheriting from Sayyidina Yunus that maqam. He was also in a seclusion inside a whale belly for many years. He asked Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for a visit, to visit him, to visit Prophet, and asked Prophet to extend his hand for him to kiss the hand of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That has been granted. It's going to happen, and 313 of Mawlana Sheikh's murids are going to be taken in that event when Sayyidina Yunus the second going for his, by Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam grants that he will extend his hand. 313 of Mawlana Sheikh's murids will be present to kiss the hand of Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdal salatu wassalam. And we hope that we are between them. Murids will be allowed to kiss from one time to three times. And every time they kiss, they will receive from the heart of Prophet in their hearts. Prophet pours in their hearts spiritual knowledge that never has been known or opened from that kind of tajalli blessing. These 313 murids are going to be like stars in the sky in the events that they are coming in front of us. They will be guides for millions of people that are looking for safety of what's coming up. The events that will be coming are so huge, like an atomic reaction, how it come behind each other. It is going to be a chain reaction of events that you wake up, you see something, you sleep, you see something else. Allah has granted permission for Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to grant permission for Mahdi's alayhi salam appearance. And Awliyaullah has renewed last night their bay'ah with Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam. 7,007 Naqshbandi wali were present in Maghāratu al-Su'ada, the happy cave of Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam, together with 124,000 wali, renewing their bay'ah, their pledges to Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salatu wassalam. In his presence was, of course, spiritually, Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalu salatu wassalam, Sahaba, because every Sahaba, there is one wali for every Sahaba. 124,000 Sahaba and 124,000 wali. With Khulafa al-Rashidun were there. In front of all of this, Awliyaullah has renewed their bay'ah with Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam. He has sent a light, a spiritual light to their hearts, that from that light they are trembling from what is going to happen in front of them. As soon as their eyes saw the eyes of Mahdi alayhi salam, that light has been gone to their hearts and they begin to feel scared because of these events, that awliyaullah are scared from it. What do you think about normal people? When they extended their hand for bay'ah, he sent tranquility on their hearts and they come as they were before, very peaceful. Their tongue are non-stopping with zikrullah. Every zikr they say and they recite by ismul jalala Allah. From every word they say Allah, a spiritual light goes out covering this world, preventing the devils that we mentioned before, Hazgul Zanadil, from attacking those who are being written to be saved in the time of Mahdi alayhi salam. They protect individuals that has been given life in the time of Mahdi alayhi salam. Awliyaullah are waiting more to come in these days to their hearts, that they will inform their followers, they will inform us, inshaAllah, as it comes from their hearts. Our duty is to keep making zikrullah, to recite Quran, to praise Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to sit back and not to interfere in what is going to happen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save us. May Allah forgive us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us long life to be with Mahdi alayhi salam, to be with Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. These events are coming behind each other. Keep to yourself and keep to your family. Anyone helped in that mosque, because it is the mosque of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, it is the mosque for Mahdi alayhi salam. It is the first mosque in America that Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam has entered with his khulafa and nawab, and they prayed there because it is under their name is being established. Every person that put one penny in it, he is going to have a peaceful life in dunya and very happy life in akhirah. May Allah forgive us. Bi hurmat al-habib, bi hurmat al-fatiha. Rabbal Allah.